Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Winecast. This is another brief cast on a grape variety, or more accurately, two grape varieties that are often connected together, fairly or not, because of their alliterative names and because of their shared connection to the wines of France's southern Rhone, Counoise and Cinsaut. Let's have a look. It's likely that Counoise, our first grape, originated in the southern Rhone, though there's at least one tradition, promulgated most famously by the 19th century Provençal poet Frédéric Mistral, that claims a Spanish origin for the grape. While that's not where the weight of the evidence seems to be settling, a Spanish, especially Catalan, home for this grape isn't impossible, as it appears to be related to the white grape Picpoul. That's important in both the Languedoc-Roussillon and the neighboring region of Catalonia across the Pyrenees, where it goes by the name Picapol. Though by itself this relationship doesn't prove anything about the origin of Counoise, it at least opens up the possibility of a home on the Iberian Peninsula. Whatever its genesis, Counoise is best known for the role that it plays in the wines of the southern Rhône Valley, where it's approved as an accessory grape, meaning that it and other accessory grapes shouldn't make up more than 30% of a total blend, in the Côte du Rhône AOC and in most of the Côte du Rhône Cru, except for Lirac and Tavel. In Châteauneuf-du-Pape, with its curious rule that any of the varieties that are approved for use in its wines can be treated as a main grape, it's actually possible to make a Châteauneuf that's 100% Counoise. But don't hold your breath, since only around 0.5% of the land under vine in Châteauneuf is currently planted to this grape. So at best, it'll turn up as a minor partner in a Châteauneuf blend, and then only infrequently, usually making up between 1-5% of what's in a bottle, if it's used at all. That said, at least two châteaux, Beaucastel and La Nerthe, do make more extensive use of it in their blends, with Beaucastel in particular ramping up the number to around 10% per bottle. It's also approved as an AOC grape in Provence, where, truth told, it doesn't seem to be either widely planted or used. And it was, at least for some period of time, permitted in wines from the Pays d'Oc IGP, connected to the Languedoc. Though recent sources I consulted suggest that it's no longer authorized in that or its sub-IGPs. Outside of France, land under vine to this grape is even more limited, with a total of 58 acres planted to it in California as of 2013, as well as a few acres in Washington State and elsewhere. Given its limited plantings and its traditional role as a blending grape, is it even made into a single varietal wine? The answer is yes, but only in a limited way. I was able to find only one example of an old world varietal Counoise, an IGP wine from the Vin de Pays du Gard appellation, Domaine de Montpertuis Vignoble de la Ramière. However, since I was having trouble verifying that Counoise is still a permitted grape in this and other Pays d'Oc IGPs, I did some checking and I wasn't able to verify that examples of this wine after 2009 still contained Counoise, though I wasn't able to check every single vintage. Thus, my one example may no longer be available, and if you have any information on either the use of Counoise in this wine or other examples of old world varietal Counoise, please let me know in the comments. So, you're better off searching for new world bottlings, I think, and California, followed by Washington State in the U.S., will be your best bet. But, like many rare grapes in the wine world, all it takes is some stray vines here and there, and you never know where you're going to find a bottle of varietal Counoise turning up. If you do find some, what will it be like? Well, Counoise produces wines that are dark in color, tending toward purple actually, low in tannin, and medium to light-bodied in character. They're also high in acid and showcase blue and red fruits, particularly blueberry and or strawberry, along with some peppery notes as well as baking spices like anise and allspice. Counoise tends to produce uncomplicated, straightforward wines driven by fruit, and that quality, along with its bright acid, make it great for, quote, offsetting the reductive tendencies of Syrah and Mourvèdre, two of its traditional partners in the Rhone, to borrow a phrase from Patrick Comiskey's excellent book, American Rhone, that was a great source of information in preparing this cast. How about Cinsaut, that you'll see spelled with or without the L, though pronounced in the same way in either case? For starters, it's much more widely planted than Counoise, managing to clock in at 25th most planted variety in the world based on data for 2010, and that's down a bit from 20th most planted in 2000 and 18th in 1990. Its major plantings in descending order are located in France, where at one point it was 4th most planted red in the country, Algeria, Morocco, South Africa, and Tunisia. It's a hardy, heat and drought-resistant grape, as well as a cold and disease-resistant grape for that matter, making it ideal for growing areas at the limit of traditional quality wine grape production, like North Africa and the Middle East, and it also has a presence in older wine-growing areas in the Middle East, like Turkey and Lebanon. In terms of its use, like Counoise, it's approved as a main grape in Châteauneuf-du-Pape, but then what isn't? As well as in Lirac for both reds and rosés, as well as in Tavel and Vaqueras for rosé production. Otherwise, again like Counoise, it has accessory grape status in the rest of the red-producing Southern Rhone crews, as well as in the Côte du Rhône AOC. It also figures as a varietal and blending grape in Provence and the Languedoc at both the AOC and IGP levels. In South Africa, where a fair amount is planted and produced, it goes under the name Hermitage, and it was crossed intentionally with Pinot Noir in 1925 to produce a well-known grape that goes under the portmanteau name of Pinotage. Though Cinsaut is more common as a single varietal wine than Counoise, its major calling, at least in terms of quality wine production, is still as a blending grape. With one of its most famous uses in that capacity being in the highly regarded red wines of the Lebanese producer Chateau Musard, where it typically makes up a significant part of the blend along with Cabernet Sauvignon and Carignan. Still, you can find a lot of examples of it as a varietal wine out there, and you should start by looking for expressions of it as a varietal rosé, particularly from the Pays d'Oc IGP in the Languedoc and the Coteau de Pierre Vert AOC in Provence. As for varietal reds, you'll find those in Languedoc IGPs too, but the real ticket, I think, is in bottlings from South Africa, particularly from Stellenbosch and Swartland, and from California and Washington State. These can be rare, but are worth the effort to seek out. So, what's Cinsaut like when it's made as a single varietal wine? It'll be light-bodied and low in tannin, but packing a wallop of acid, the brightest and most intense acidity, in fact, of any of the red Rhone varieties. That acid helps to show off a core of red fruit, supported by notes of dried herbs and wildflowers, all of which is typically pretty uncomplicated both on the nose and the palate. Though red wines often get all the love, don't ignore the grape as a rosé. And, in fact, that may be its most highly prized expression, with pinks made of Cinsaut coming off as particularly bright and fresh. Finally, both of our grapes, Counoise and Cinsaut, make excellent food wines, with a lot of the credit going to their mouth-watering acidity. Because these are uncomplicated and straightforward wines, however, they work best with equally straightforward dishes that are typically lightly though well-seasoned, and that foreground a single component of the dish as opposed to a symphony of flavors. Think a simple grilled chop or roast chicken as opposed to a curry or a stew, say. And again, thanks to the acid, they're great with dishes that feature tomatoes in a starring role. Thanks for joining me for another Winecast. As always, I hope this cast was helpful and interesting to you, and if it was, please like and subscribe if you haven't already. Please always feel free to leave a question, comment, or suggestion in the comment section, and I'll try to respond to each of these in a timely fashion. Finally, this cast was released on Veterans Day 2018 in the United States, and from me to all of my listeners who are veterans or active duty military, a heartfelt thanks for your service and your commitment to duty. I'm the Unknown Winecaster, and I'm out. Enjoy the grape, but always enjoy it responsibly.